In this video, we want to cover how to place the Fibonacci ruler within Track and Trade. I also want to make a note here that these features are exactly the same whether we're using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I'm using the futures version for this demonstration. In this chart, to select the Fibonacci ruler, very simply, we click the button for Fibonacci, and if we have the preferences tab selected, you'll notice that we have all the preferences for the Fibonacci ruler. It looks a little bit overwhelming, but if you think about it, it's really not. It's very simple. All we're doing is we're talking about the different lines that make up the different sections of the Fibonacci ruler. This first section, of course, is just the ruler section itself. So as we draw the ruler, we simply hold down the left mouse button, start at the top of the trend, and we begin to draw to the bottom of the trend. So you can see that we now have the bottom and the top of the trend identified through the Fibonacci ruler, indicating that we are looking at an A, B pattern, and then this would be the Fibonacci ruler going through the price and time. Now you'll notice on the Fibonacci ruler, we also have the time zones they're listed here as well, and you can see them listed by the vertical lines here, and they're outlined with the numbers across the top. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 5. These are Fibonacci numbers, but these are representing the number of price bars. So 13, 21, 34, 55 price bars out. So this is how far out that these price bars go, and you'll know the further they extend, the further the Fibonacci time zones or timelines occur. This is how we draw those, very simply by right clicking, and you can turn the time zones on, turn the time zones off. So the next thing I want to talk about, very simply, so we can see this a little bit better, let's slide all the way to the bottom, and we're going to increase the font size. I'm going to bring that up to 10, and I'm going to make it bold, and we've got show text on so we can see the text very clearly. Snap, of course, is snapping it so that we can snap it to the exact high and low of the trend, and that would be these points here that would touch the exact trend levels. And so this is the snap to and the drawing of the different trends. So now what I want to do is I want to come in and just simply customize the tool a little bit. And so you can see that these lines here are selected. They're turned on, Fibonacci 61.8, 50, and 38.2. Now again, this video is not meant to go through and explain all the numbers and what they mean. Those are done in different videos, but this is meant to help you learn how to turn these features on and off. So simply by selecting these features, you can see that they're turned on and off, and this is how we turn them on and off. So we can turn them back on. Let's see, turn them back on. We want all of these turned on the way we had it. Now if we want to have the Fibonacci 78.6 or 76.4% levels turned on, we turn those out here. The reason there are two numbers, 78.6 and 76.4, is because the calculations can be done in two different ways and to get a different result, whether you get 78.6 or 76.4. So if you want to see those calculations, those are done here. Either squaring gives you the 78.6 or the division gives you 76.4. So if you are that concerned about the numbers, whether you like 78.6 or if you like 76.4, you can choose the different math method here that gives you the different results for those outlying projection levels. So we can turn those on off in this region here as well. We can also change the colors. I like to come in here sometimes and make these colors a little bit more easier to see. So we'll come in and make this one red. Maybe we'll make this one green. And we'll make this one green, so we have the sweet spot outlined in the center. Well, let's make that one red and then make this one green as well. So we have our color line for the center of the sweet spot of the Fibonacci ruler. So now we have that ability. Now to turn on the retracement levels, retracements are markets have a tendency to retrace above or below the initial triangle formation or the initial setup of the Fibonacci ruler. So we can either turn those on by clicking the projections here, which would project out the bottom because we're going down in this case because we're starting at the top of the trend, projecting A, B, and you'll see this would be D down in here, A, B, C, D. So we are projecting down, so that would be projections. If we had drawn the trend tool or the Fibonacci ruler from the bottom up like this and then turned on the projections, you would notice that it would project up as opposed to down. It depends on which way you draw the tool that gives you the projections going either up or down. Since you'll notice that A is on the bottom here, B is on the top. Here is we have A on the top, B on the bottom. So we're projecting towards the next level. So that's how we get those. And then of course we can do that with the right click menu as well. If we right click on the tool, we have the ability of turning off the projections here. or the predictions, and then having the control or the retracements, having the control over the different lines if those are turned on. So we have the projections turned on. We can turn on and off each individual line here in the right click menu, and that's how I access this menu here, is just simply right clicking on the ruler itself, and then I have access to the different lines just as I would over in the preferences tab. So in this case we can come in here, and so let's go ahead and turn on the retracements, which is going to put the retracements to the upper side in this case, because retracements would be above us since we're looking at the market going short. So this is, if we squeeze down the Fibonacci ruler, you see that we have the Fibonacci ruler drawn through the center point here from A to B, projecting lower, retracing higher. So that's how we would draw that in there, and that's how you turn those features on with the time zone laid in there. And this is how we're going to calculate the trend going out into the future. So we have the ability to come in and customize each section. We can come in and customize we've customized the background or the individual lines for the Fibonacci ruler itself. We could do the same thing for the retracements. We could come in here and change the colors and make them a little bit more specific to our goals that we would like to have, or that we would like to see that these markets could project out to or retrace to. And we can come down and change these colors as well. We also have the ability to change these to different line styles, different colors, line thicknesses and styles to draw attention to the specific areas that we're most interested in seeing the markets retrace or project out to. And most of these features that are over here in the right hand side, these are also the ability to also turn those on and off here in the right click menu. Now, one other feature I want to talk about is the prediction level. So I'm going to start over. I'm going to delete this tool. I'm going to bring the chart back, and we're going to do a Fibonacci ruler where we're going to do, again, we'll go from the top to the bottom, and this is just the defaults right off of Track and Trade, so TNT defaults. And now what we're going to do, instead of turning on either the projections or the retracements, we're going to turn on the predictions. Now, what's the difference between predictions and retracements or projections? The projections, display the projections, shows a grid across the timeline so that we have time versus the different Fibonacci levels. So we have Fibonacci projection levels out here that we can see the markets are moving through price and time. So I'm going to turn those back off. Those are projections, display projections turned off. Now I'm going to right click and I'm going to turn on predictions. Now the predictive line is based on the retracement of the previous move. It's not just a series of Fibonacci price and timelines. It has to do with the actual retracement of the overall market. So you can see that we have A, B, A, C, B, D. But if we have to read this, we have to read A, B, C, D. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab C, which is our handle, and you'll notice that we can move this up and down. This is now a retracement level. So we're going to grab C and we're going to pull it back to the C level, which is this retracement right here. And we can see that this market retraced to 76.0%, almost exactly. So the market came down, it stopped here, retraced back to 76.4, and then it dropped down again right into our sweet spot, down into this time zone of the D zone. So this is the D, would be the prediction level, or where we anticipate the market rallying to or falling to in this case. So again, we're going from A, B, C, D. And this ties in very closely to another tool that we use, which is the 1-2-3 tool, which we also use to project and predict the same basic structure to predict off into the future of where these same ABC projections go. And this is how that is done as well. So you can see that they work hand in hand. The Fibonacci projection or prediction tool, ABCD, works hand in hand with our 1-2-3 tool, 1-2-3 predicting out to the level D point. And so this is how this is done using both tools in combination, the Fibonacci ruler with the 1-2-3 tool, and the preferences of the Fibonacci ruler, being able to customize it to your desired liking. Now, to remove this from the chart, very simply, you can either right click on the screen and hit delete, or you can, if the tool is selected and has the handles on it, you can hit the delete key on your keyboard and it removes it from the screen as well. Same with the 1-2-3 tool.